Hey guys, this is Austin. There are a lot of important things to consider when buying a new computer, but I've got a question for you. What's the most important one when it comes to responsiveness? Is it having an awesome processor, ton of memory, maybe a huge screen, or is it your lowly hard drive? Actually, yeah, that is exactly what it is. So the standard hard drive that you'll find in a lot of computers today is a bottleneck in almost every single thing that you do. Well, maybe not every single thing, but you know, loading programs, or booting Windows, or I don't know, loading up pictures of Ken. These are all things that are much, much slower on a mechanical hard drive, and that, my friends, is where Intel Optane Memory comes in, who are awesome enough to sponsor this video so we can answer a very simple question. What exactly is Optane Memory? Take this Dell Inspiron I have here. On the surface, it looks pretty similar to a lot of other laptops, but thanks to improvements in processing power, specifically with the 8th Gen Core processors, you can do a lot more work a lot more efficiently than you used to be able to do on a system like this. And yet, Grandpa Hard Drive is keeping us down. I'm gonna say Grandpa Hard Drive and you're gonna like it. If you've got a big budget, by all means go for a full SSD. It'll definitely give you the speed, but the issue is cost. Now if you need anything more than say a couple hundred gigs of space, things get pricey very, very quickly. Especially when you're spending less than $1,000 on a system, it can be really tempting to go for flashy options like more RAM, but the thing is, it won't really make a big difference in day-to-day use for most people. Sure, if you're one of those people who have 100 tabs open in Chrome all the time, then you probably do need more RAM, and maybe to reevaluate your life decisions. But the best way to think about RAM versus a hard drive is like this. Having more RAM will allow you to have more things open at once, but having a faster drive will mean that all those things will load much more quickly. That's where Optane Memory comes in. Now, the important thing to know is that this is not a replacement for a hard drive. It's an addition to it. So the way that Optane Memory works is that when you're using your computer normally, there's an algorithm that runs in the background, and it's constantly analyzing which files you're pulling from the hard drive. The ones that you're pulling most, such as Windows or your programs or whatever the case is, will then be cached to the Optane module, which will massively speed things up without hurting your capacity. There are a few things to understand about how all this works. Now the first thing is the actual Optane module itself. One of the keys is capacity. So with a standard SSD, you're usually getting at least 256 gigs of space. However, an Optane module only needs to be 16 or 32 gigabytes depending on which one you pick up. And that is because it is sharing the space with your standard hard drive, which can be a terabyte or 2 terabytes or 14 terabytes in the case of our ultimate gaming PC. This means a few things. First of all, it dramatically cuts down on the price per gigabyte, which is a big deal, regardless of whether you're building an over-the-top gaming PC or buying a thin and light laptop. Secondly, it means that you still have the mechanical hard drive and all the capacity that goes with it. It really is the best of both worlds. You have the capacity of a large hard drive, but with the responsiveness and speed of an SSD. Now, it's not perfect right out of the box. Optane Memory does need a little bit of time to process and analyze all the different programs, apps, and files that you use on a regular basis, but the idea is that Optane is going to make your computer faster over time as it's more and more well optimized versus, well, basically every other computer ever, which gets slower and slower with the inevitable march of time. Inevitable march of time. This all sounds great in theory, but how does it actually work? To demo, I have a couple devices, starting with by far the most common method of using Optane Memory, a laptop such as this HP Pavilion X360. This is a well-rounded system with a Core i7, 12 gigs of RAM, dedicated AMD graphics, and a 1 terabyte hard drive that is backed up by a 16 gigabyte Optane module. It works exactly like any other Windows system. Want to load up Chrome? Bam, it's there. How about jumping into a quick game of PUBG? It's a lot faster than a traditional mechanical hard drive. On the other hand, we have a full-on gaming PC, which has a whopping 14 terabyte hard drive, which is accelerated with Intel Optane. Now mind you, this is a very extreme way of using Optane, but the point stands. We've already done a full video on this PC, which you guys can check out, but the way it works is that we're using a 32 gigabyte Intel Optane module paired with our huge Steam library to get some seriously fast speeds, even though we have 14 terabytes of storage. The best part is you don't have to do anything different. As far as Windows is concerned, I have a 1 terabyte hard drive inside my HP. However, what's going on in the background is that Optane Memory is speeding up everything without me having to do a thing. Now, of course, this isn't for everyone. If you're buying a high-end workstation, for example, you probably have the budget for a huge SSD. For a lot of people, though, this is a really nice middle ground between a super high-end system and a budget option with a glitchily slow hard drive. Whether you want to build a new game PC or buy that new laptop, if I can communicate anything in this video, it's this. If you're getting a new system, don't rely on just a mechanical hard drive. There are just better options out there, including Intel Optane Memory.